Playoff fever has immersed South Florida as we are at Hard Rock Stadium here in Miami. Coming up, we begin a triple header here on Wild Card Sunday as it'll be the LA Chargers taking on the Miami Dolphins. Strap in, the first of three on this Sunday. What a day we have in store. Super Wild Card Weekend on EA Sports. And they will elect to not bring this one out as our first drive will begin at the 25. Here's Achan to start the drive. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. Just like that, a pickup of 20 on their first play from scrimmage. The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already. Now Tua. Takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. Second and 10. Tua with a quick throw, caught out wide. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four.
But, Charles, what a rookie season he had catching the football, over 1,000 yards on the year, and he comes through there with a nice grab.
And we've seen wide receivers in recent years come in and have big years right away. And you think about Justin Jefferson in 2020, 1,400 yards and huge impact on his team and on the league. This guy, he's following his footsteps. He's an impact guy here in year one.
Give him 15 yards on that one, and the Dolphins have a first down. Slot man moves right. Now Achan on first and 10. And he'll follow his blockers there all the way down to the 23-yard line. 11 more on that one, and another first down.
Good running right there. And this is a man who's a 1,000-yard rusher in the regular season, so you know he's going to get his chances. And he picks up nice yardage on that one.
They're looking for Higgins, but it is intercepted. Picked off by J.C. Jackson. And the Chargers are going to have it here as they'll start at their own 24-yard line. Nobody ever wants the interception on the opening drive to happen, but when it happens in the playoffs, it feels like it's a bigger deal. What a rough start.
And how about these visitors? The defense just went right on the field and seized momentum. You know, almost like they're saying, okay, no one expects us to win this one. Let's go ahead and give them a shock early. Took the ball from the home team and put them in the hole.
Because this crowd, one of the best in the league, especially this time of year, it's going to be tough to take them out of it, but that's a heck of a start.
Solid running there. And, CD, we hear so much about what it takes to win in the playoffs. Most people like to include having a strong running game in their assessment. And with this man in the backfield, this group has a strong running game without a doubt.
Absolutely agree with you there, because in terms of yardage, he's a top five running back in the league. And in terms of impact on a game, not many better than him. And when they're flowing and he's carrying the ball consistently, they're tough to beat.
And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. It'll go as a gain of 11 at a Charger first.
Well, when you're a road team in the playoffs, when you're a wild card, what's the one thing you need to be able to do to stay in football games? Run the football. And that's an excellent job right there of identifying where to go and picking up good yardage.
They go play action here on first down. Buying time to his left. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
Nice progress down the field. Was halted by that incompletion. They could try for some safe yards here to get things moving again, or keep throwing it and pushing it downfield to try and pick up bigger yardage.
Off
off the play fake. He'll look to throw. Blitz coming, and down he goes. A well-designed corner blitz that gets him for a loss of 8 yards. How about that? The defense's first sack. It doesn't come from one of the usual suspects up front. It comes from the secondary.
Yeah, I think they caught the quarterback off guard a little bit because he wasn't able to account for the possibility of that blitz and change the blocking assignments. He comes through and puts him on the ground.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. That's into a crowd and intercepted. Picked off by Xavier Howard.
And I think this is a situation where a quarterback coach in the sideline is going to talk to a signal caller and say, listen, it's third and long and it's still early in the game. Let's not force things here. If we don't feel good about it, let's just check something down and pump the football.
After the turnover, it's Tua. Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete.
I think we can all understand what they're thinking right now. They take over the ball in field goal range after the turnover, so they've got that in their hip pocket. But they've got to go for the end zone and turn this into a bigger point. Their thinking is a touchdown is really what they should get from starting here. Getting 3 points at the end of this drive, that would feel disappointing.
That is caught by Waddle. Touchdown, Miami. Jalen Waddle, 28 yards. And the Dolphins will strike first here in this wild card matchup. On that connection, it looked like they maybe had some pre-play communication. Maybe one of them noticed an area that was open to the defense to get the pass to.
When you put the time in, sometimes you have that great silent communication that you just noticed right there, because the best quarterback receiver combos in the NFL, they know how to make those adjustments at the line of scrimmage when they see something pre-play, and they get it done there.
After the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. Fair catch, going to be taken, and this will be moved out to the 25. The Charger drive about to get going. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number two?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they like better than others, where they think they have an advantage.
And now off to the races, down the right side. Touchdown, LA. A big play there. 75 yards. And the Chargers are able to strike quickly here as they are in for six. And we didn't even get a chance to settle in for that drive. A quick strike of 75 yards, and they find the end zone.
Don't you get the sense that film study was behind this one, that they saw something that they thought they could take advantage of? The key is calling it in the right situation, knowing when it exists to go to it. They did exactly that. They've got to feel really good about what they did in advance of this game.
Just looking down at the sideline now, their defense is like, man, can you have strung that out just a few plays? Give us a break. Back out there.
Hey, man, give that water break and get on out there and play.
So all even at seven now as they kick it away. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that. And Charles is deep. Here he goes, right side. Jalen Waddle. Touchdown, Dolphins. Jalen Waddle. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Dolphins have taken the lead. See, generate some pretty good offense here in this first quarter.
It's been a wild start to this quarter, as you know. And now, with that lead that we're seeing, can they retaliate? I get the sense this is going to go back and forth all game long.
And that probably won't be the last long touchdown that we see in this one. Now, after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. And he'll elect not to run with it. The fair catch will move this out to the 25-yard line. The Charger drive about to get going.
Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown. Sometimes that's not really true, but last drive, that was the case. One play to get into the end zone, and now they'll try to duplicate that success here.
And it's rare for those moments to happen. Incredible when they do. And you saw the celebration. Pure, unbridled joy after that one.
Here's second and seven now from the 28. He'll look to throw. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains. Hands it off out of the gun. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness. He's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss. Runner pass and make the appropriate moves.
He crashed down hard there. He was ready for that running play. On third down, it dropped to throw. Laying out is Davis, and he's got the football. His first catch of this wild card game, and it's good for a first down.
A Hall of Fame coach once said, there are no medals for trying. And that wasn't a trying effort, was it? That was a winning effort. How about that great catch?
Excellent. They know, hey, you lose this game, you get a ding or two. You got 7 months to heal. They're going to go all out. Through one quarter, 14-7, our score. Charger football to start quarter number two, as they've got it with a first and 10.
Come on, come on.
And they'll run on the inside handoff. And he gets forward up the middle, but only for a couple. It'll be second down.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
And a good push up front, and he's able to navigate his way down inside the 30. It's a gain of 11 and a first down, L.A.
A good run there off right tackle in an old-school NFL football. The right side of the offensive line, often known as the nasty side. The left side, usually the technical side. Kind of reminds me of the old Atlanta Falcons 2009-2010. That's how they constructed their offensive line.
27-yard line.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. Caught right side, Davis. Call it a gain of 6 on the play. And that's going to bring up 3rd and 2.
They kept the receiver in the short field, but that let his quarterback get the ball quickly to him before either guy in double coverage could react.
Still to go. 3rd down now. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Pass taken in by his big tight end. Touchdown from 21 yards away. And the Chargers are an extra point away from drawing level. And nowadays in NFL football, you have to account for all the receivers, sure, but the tight end's such a weapon, and they prove it right there.
Oh, without a doubt. And we're seeing now the golden age of tight ends catching the football. I go back to Kellen Winslow. Uh-huh. To me, he was a prototype of what we're seeing today. We're seeing it each and every week now.
This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. Charles, this offense, they've been on a roll. 2 drives ago, they scored. Remember, last drive was that one play touchdown strike, so now they're looking to make it 3 for 3.
You know, I talked to a Hall of Famer one time about, hey, when you're on defense and these types of things are happening to you, what goes through your mind? And he told me at that point, it's not about schemes. It's not about what's called from the sideline. It's about players. Who's going to make a play, make a stand, and stop this offense from doing what they've been doing?
To his throw, caught by Higgins. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. His first catch of this wild card game, and it's good for a first down. They'll bring a receiver in motion left. He's going to get it on the jet sweep. And he's going to take this one up only to about the 44-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be 2nd down.
Defensively, they had that one pretty well figured out.
Yeah, one of the things about this play, it can be even more effective when you run a lot of motion and there's plenty of times you don't hand it off.
From the 44-yard line, here's 2nd down and 8. Tua sets up to pass it. Throw caught by Achane. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Devon Achane, 56 yards. And the Dolphins have taken the lead. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And the lead is now 21-14. Touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. And Davis content just to bring this out to the 25-yard line. The Charger drive about to get going. They'll look for a drive to tie this up, down 21-14 as they have it first and 10. The Dolphins get there this time, and they bring him down. A loss of four that time on the sack, and it brings up second.
So this has been a lot like a tennis match, hasn't it? Back and forth. Both of these offenses having their way so far. So maybe the question isn't who's going to score the most points in this game. Maybe it's who's going to get some stops.
Yeah, absolutely. And that sack, finally a first step in the right direction for a stop. Second and 14. Throw right side, caught by Davis. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 17 yards on the catch and run. It's a first down. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. And that one's going to be off target and incomplete.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
Now a second and 10. Back to throw here. And that is caught. It's Davis. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. A gain there of 21 yards.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts. So as they talk it over, we step aside. Now they contend with a second and 12 after the loss. To throw. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that is incomplete.
Well, Sony did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come up and downfield, but they never did.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. To throw. He's got his target. That's complete. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins 26. The Chargers passing game rolling a bit here. They've got another first.
Very nicely done there on the reception. And what an impact this rookie made on this offense, Charles, in the regular season.
Yeah, he's a big part of why they are where they are. He stepped into an important role, embraced it, and in a lot of ways expanded it, and immediately made a connection with his quarterback.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Well, a momentary speed bump there with that throw partner. The defense had other ideas, and they're trying to mount a small stand before this drive reaches the end zone.
Again, he'll drop to throw. And give him 10 that time as he was able to get away from the pressure and get a nice game. The Dolphins going to take their second timeout. fans to head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Here comes third and about a foot. And a quick throw here, that's complete. Now the Dolphins will use the last of their timeouts. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. And no field goal try here from the red zone. Offense out there. They'll go for it on fourth. And boy, is he close. Did he get there? No, they're going to say he's short the line to gain. The fourth down play doesn't work for the Chargers. And this 10-play drive winds up yielding nothing. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And not an abundance of time remains on the clock, Charles, but you would think more than enough to try to extend this lead before intermission.
And when you're talking about extending the lead, I think you're talking about aiming for the end zone, because there is plenty of time for that. The fallback is to get three. But in your mind, you put six on the board right before the half. That's a heck of a dagger and great momentum to carry into the locker room.
A good pickup there, 22.
Oh, I like that play call there. After a run for good yards, you get a defense thinking they'll go back to the well. So that's a great time to call play action and give your receivers a little extra edge. And they complete the pass there for another first down.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Going to the air, Tagovailoa. They'll let this go deep for Waddle. This is caught inside the 15. And he's out of bounds, almost gets to the 10. A gain of 39 that time.
Well, they've looked his way quite a bit in this first half, and with good reason. You can see it there. He has such a handful defensively, just too hard to keep him under wraps, and delivers a big play here for this offense.
So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. Tua gonna throw. And caught by Cooper for a Dolphins touchdown. A 12-yard touchdown grab. And the Dolphins will extend their lead in the final minute of the half. Extra point up and good by Sanders, and the lead now up to 14. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. The Charger drive about to get going. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot. The good signal callers will never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. The Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. First down, he'll drop to throw it. Escaping the pressure right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
One thing you always worry about when he breaks the pocket is he going to take off with it? That time, the pressure was starting to close in, and he's just got to throw this one away.
Here's second and 10. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And he will find his man on the end round, complete. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins 40. And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number two. Now with 5 seconds left, not really enough time to run another play and then stop it. So on comes the field goal unit. They'll spot it at the 47, so call it a 57-yard attempt. And this is good from 57 yards out. That was bombs away right there. And that will get the disadvantage now back down to 11. Maybe a little fortunate there. That was leaking a little, maybe leaking a lot, but he got it.
Yeah, he actually was able to make it work. How about the body language, though, right? As he watched that ball leak to the right, trying to bring it back in. And had just enough to get it done.
This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
Chargers 17.
Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Both teams try to avoid being one and done in these playoffs as we start the second half of this AFC wildcard game. And the fair catch signaled for and taken, so they'll begin this third quarter from their 25-yard line. The Charger drive about to get going. And Charles, that had to be an interesting locker room at halftime. This is a team that's had so much success this year. Haven't really had to deal with a lot of adversity at halftime, to be honest. But now here they are with their playoff lives on the line.
And I think when you're moving to that interesting locker room, you're just wondering, how are they handling that bit of adversity that they're seeing right now? Because I think this is a team that has to look to lean on the veterans at this point. We know we're better than this. We've proved it all season. Let them disseminate that confidence through the locker room. But this opening drive, it'll be an important one for them to give them a little jolt of confidence moving forward.
He's going to float this one deep right side. This is intercepted. Picked up by Xavier Howard. There he goes, left side. He may go. Takeaway, 6 points as well.
And you just knew that for this team to advance, it had to get a big performance from this unit. To this point, they delivered.
Extra point, and good. is away. But no run back here. Fair catch, and this will come out to the 25. The Charger drive about to get going. I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
Play action. They'll throw. He'll buy some time right. And he wisely will throw that one away.
They have to like what they've done defensively here at the outset of this drive. They forced a couple of incomplete passes, bring up a third and 10. Don't be surprised to bring a little pressure on this snap.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Looking to throw. Able to find the open man. That's complete. Still going inside the 20. And all the way in for a Charger touchdown. Darius Davis, 75 yards. And the Chargers get a bit closer. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts. All right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. But no matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go around. A nice grab there for a guy coming off a terrific season, one that saw him have over 100 catches.
And when you have that many catches, that means you're a full part of the offense. And let's face it, he's been as good as anyone in the NFL this year. So it figures he's going to play a big role in whether his team can advance in the playoffs.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Achane on the counter. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Not a lot of running room there. Not a place to make a cut and kind of exit out because they had everything bottled up. Looked to me like the linemen were taking on their blocks really well and giving up no creases.
Here's second and 7. Option handoff now to Achane. And hard running's going to get him over the 40 to the 42.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Third and 3. Again, it's Achane. Power Rivers passed him at midfield. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
So from Charger territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 48-yard line. Oh, the motion comes too late, and this is going to be a delay.
Well, everybody was up there ready at the line of scrimmage, CD, but no snap, and the delay of game ensued.
Yeah, and I'm sure their head coach is asking the exact same thing. What's going on out there? Almost like they thought they had more time than actually was on the clock.
The delay of game backs him up 5, first and 15. Now Tua. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. It'll be a gain of 5. And that'll make it second down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. 68 yards rushing for him now to this point. All right, I got to ask you, with these RPOs, essentially the quarterback has three options, right? So what's different from that versus the triple option that we see the service academies run at the college level?
As a general rule, the triple option at the college level, most things are called outside of the quarterback faking it to the runner and then keeping it himself and maybe having a trail back. What I mean is, in the NFL,
look at this, middle of the field, a breakaway. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Dolphins touchdown. Devon Achane, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Dolphins continue to show why it pays to play at home in the postseason as they add on to their lead. Sanders on for the extra point. And the lead is up to 18 now. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. Oh, a good-looking return set up here. He's past the 30. He might score. He will score. Touchdown, Chargers. It's been a back-and-forth game, a lot of points on the board, and that return right there kind of indicative of how this thing's gone.
Yeah, you've seen both teams go at it, and as you just pointed out, both of them have found the end zone. But just like in boxing, you know the blow that hurts the most? The one you didn't see coming, and that often is the case when it comes in special teams.
Now the extra point try forthcoming. And that one makes this an 11-point deficit now. So let's try this again. After the kick return TD, here's yet another kickoff. And we will not see an attempt to match that return touchdown as this will be a touchback and bring it out to the 25. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. Their lead down to 2 scores after the touchdown a moment ago as they start with a first and 10. Looking to pass. Tua. They'll let this go deep for Waddle. That's caught inside the 20. Touchdown, Dolphins. Jalen Waddle saving his best for the playoffs with his third touchdown of the game. And the Dolphins get another third quarter. touchdown to add on to that lead. I don't think you can get any more efficient or tidy, whatever word you want to use than that. And one play, 75 yards, end zone.
Yeah, efficient, tidy, excellent words. How about explosive? 75 yards, one play. That means everyone handled their assignment, doesn't it? It doesn't just mean that the defense broke down. They really executed the way that was drawn up on the whiteboard. Big time play, big time result.
Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. And Davis content just to bring this out to the 25-yard line. The Charger drive about to get going. A strong showing their last time out. They scored the touchdown, but Charles, they look up and they're still down double digits, so you feel like just to keep pace, this drive probably needs to end in the end zone as well.
Yeah, and I think the best move for them is to not worry about how far they are down on the scoreboard, but to just remember the last drive and how it ended. Go ahead and try and repeat that. Then you can look at the scoreboard and see where this game is.
And the job becomes twice as difficult now. After the sack, it's second and 20.
19 tight, 19 tight.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Trying to stretch the field with Schultz. And he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete.
I'm sure this isn't a novel thought, but maybe run some simpler routes instead of trying to get it all back in one shot. Defense certainly appears to be ready for it. Try and get it back little by little instead of in big chunks.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. They'll look to throw here. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free and it's fourth down. On is the Chargers punter now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. He gets this away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. And the punt over the side in the air, and the spot will be inside the 35. First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive. And now you've got the clock winding down here in the third quarter. You're three scores to the good. What's your approach on this drive?
Too early to fully commit to playing the clock game. Yet at the same time, you're also not going pell-mell like you would in two-minute offense. This is what NFL offenses call four-minute football. Take the clock out of the game a little bit, wind it down, but at the same time, keep advancing the ball down the field.
Cooper, the man in motion left. Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. That one good for 13 and a Dolphin first down.
And in a situation like this, you're in the second half with the lead, trying to get to the division round. They're going to let him do his thing on the ground, and that's a great run there to pick up a first down.
Now Tua just going to bat this forward on the end around. And a great read by the secondary. They come up to stop that touch pass before it can even get back to the line.
Brings up second and 11 at the Chargers 42-yard line.
Up the middle, Achane. And he'll be taken down after a decent gain, and that will bring us to the end of this third quarter play. One quarter remains for the right to survive round one here in the AFC. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Dolphins on third down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. This time it's 3rd and 3. Rolling to his left. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Higgins. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down, I do believe. Yes, he's got it by about a yard there on 3rd and 3. So 1st and 10 now from the 30. They'll send a receiver here in motion right. Running left, Achan. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. And give him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6.
4 yards on the pickup. 2nd and 6.
Achan here. They stay on the ground. That's a big loss of 3, and it brings up 3rd down. Run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the 4th quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it, and the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're just trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps, trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
They got to get to the 20 to keep the drive alive on 3rd down.
All right, offense, keep pushing the ball.
And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. Not at all what they envisioned on 3rd down. 3 yards in the wrong direction.
Jason Sanders for the Dolphin field goal. A 49-yard attempt.
The kick by Sanders is good, and the Dolphins will add on their lead.
Well, ultimately, not really sure that they're going to need those 3 points, but they'll take the 3, and they pad that lead.
Yeah, this one's already wrapped up, but you and I both know, if you're an offensive coordinator, you never let up on the gas unless the head coach tells you to do so, and maybe you've actually clicked him off in your headset so that you can keep calling plays and trying to add to this lead.
And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. The Charger drive about to get going. They are most likely staring at a cold end to their season here in this wild card round. Nothing has gone right so far. And they are, to be frank, in desperation mode now as they begin with a 1st and 10. He's going to float this one deep right side. That's caught at the 25. A big play there for L.A. 61 yards. So barely time to catch our breath. Here's 1st and 10 just outside the red zone. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And he's going to be intercepted for the 3rd time thus far. And the Dolphins are going to take possession here as they've got it at their own 4-yard line.
Dolphins take over 1st and 10 at their own 4-yard line.
All right, let's go.
Yeah, let's put 6 on the board, fellas.
The drive starts with a run from Achan. And he's able to get this up just shy of the 15. 124 yards rushing for him now as he has been a central figure in trying to get his guys to the 2nd round. So still backed up, but the situation not as dire now. 1st and 10 at the 14. They give to Achan on the option. They're going to snuff this play out behind the line. We have not seen that much today. 2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12. On this day, the ground has been his, but at least on that individual play, we just saw the defense finally with a win.
Yeah, they finally got one, and that's a win for them, but all game long, he's seen the holes, and they've been huge for him. Kind of like a baseball hitter in the zone. The ball seems bigger, and he's just whacked.
And that's caught inside the 35. Touchdown! Jalen Waddle, 88 yards. And the Dolphins up the lead to 4 scores now here in this 4th quarter. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And that'll increase their lead to 28. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. This is going to be returned from middle of the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. The Charger drive about to get going. Well, this game, it has had no shortage of offense. They've been able to put up a decent amount of points on this side, Charles. They just have not been able to keep pace with the other offense they're going against here.
Yeah, that's a good way of pointing things out, because now...
And he's in for a Charger touchdown. A great play there. 77 yards. And the Chargers get a small measure of revenge as they cut into this fourth quarter deficit. Extra point right down the middle, and that'll cut the lead back down to 21. The kick unit on here for the Chargers as they will send this one away. He will return this from deep in the end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And you'd have to say they have done what they set out to do in this wild card round. It won't get easier from here, of course, but they'll certainly have some momentum built up for when they hit the road in the divisional round next weekend. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up third down. Now, right where this set of downs started, they need a full 10 here to pick up the first down and move the chains. On third down, Achan. And they will stop him short. They get him to the ground at the 27. No first down. He's able to chew up 8 yards on the carry there, but still, fourth down upcoming. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. And that one hits at the 7, but bounds into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback.
Okay, ready?
The Charger drive about to get going. And at this point, maybe you say, you know, it was a good effort really just to make the playoffs. They couldn't win their division but did earn a wild card berth. It does appear, however, that their season is just a few minutes away from ending in one and done fashion.
They'll give him 4 yards there, and it's second down. Decent start to the drive, but let's face it, they need a lot of things to go right in a short amount of time, down 3 scores.
Yeah, they're going to run their 2-minute offense here in this game, but this is for future games. Can they get better and be ready for the next time, hopefully with a chance to win?
Second and 6. Flushed out right. He's going to let it fly. This is caught inside the 15. A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. They had the huge play last time. Here it is a much smaller gain of 2.
Well, we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone and the frustration, the body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
Flush to his right. And he comes back with one complete. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch. And that'll bring up fourth down.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And they
hit him as he throws, as this one's going to go straight down to the turf. Incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and as a result, their playoff run may end right here. And they take a knee. And they will take a knee here. Getting into the playoffs is one thing. Now they get to move on, just eight teams left.
The dream stays alive. Everyone's gunning for the Super Bowl. That's the ultimate. But you have to get there in incremental steps. One win today gets them one step closer.